How do we unlock this potential of these superstars in the making? How do we actually get them to deliver against the promise that we have of them? I'm going to describe that to you in five keys to focus on. I'm going to interlace it with real life experience. What we found is that as a company and as a CEO, the first thing that a young generation, new generation is looking for is, what is your mission? What are you trying to do? Now, I don't mean with a mission, I'm going to change life, I'm going to help the elephants in Africa, that would be great, but that is not what I'm looking for, a mission. They want to look at the founder and the CEO of a company, and they want to know, does that person really cares about the market that they're delivering? And whether that is a four-person company or a 50-person company, it doesn't matter. Does the CEO eat, live, and breathe the market that they do? If you're a roof layer, then you need to live in that roof layer market. And then obviously laying roofs, or you know, being a construction worker company, or being a lawyer company, then you as the founder, CEO of the company, you gotta absolutely love it. That's the mission that they're looking for. They're not just looking to work for another job. The other thing, and it's a very misunderstood thing, many cases and in many cultures over the past years, the leader would essentially keep some of their political views and views on social lifestyle back, not of interest to the employee. I can tell you right now, the next generation of people are looking to their bosses, and they're looking like, do they have the same moral values as I have? And if they're not, I'm not interested to go work for that company. The most common fear that I hear for CEOs when they go into a board meeting, they're not afraid of the board. They're afraid of the people on their team leaving. Finding good people is so important to a company now that they fear it. If you, as a CEO and as a founder, if you have views, this is the reason why being on a social media platform like a Twitter or an Instagram or a Facebook is so important to them, because they look at you beyond work. And if they don't see what they like, if they don't like what they see, they're out of there. They don't want to work with you. So you have to be really somebody, a leader that aspires, a leader that like represents them. They want to look at you as their representation. Now, in here, we have a Dutch person named Bojan Slot. And Bojan is one of those leaders in the world. As some of you may have heard, Bojan has taken on the plastic production in the world. And his primary thought is, look, we got to get that plastic out of the ocean. So he started the company. Now, what Bojan found is all that hard work that we've done over the past 50 to 100 years has gotten a lot of this plastic in the ocean. And so Bojan decided, in order to fix that, hard work won't do. And so he started to come up with blueprints and designs on how he could pull it out.